feature presentation.
Which crashed into the Mediterranean Sea on the 11th, was a single-stage, astral-propelled rocket launched 13 months ago from a site within the United States. The rocket, with its complement of 17 men, had landed on the planet Venus.
Venus?
The planet Venus?
Some of you may also have heard the story of a monster now confined here in Rome Zoo. That beast is from Venus.
Became the classic horror film of its time.
Not that room! Not that room!
Now, George Romero brings us the most intensely shocking motion picture experience for all times.
It gets up and kills. The people it kills get up and kill. This situation must be controlled before it's too late. They are multiplying too rapidly.
Dawn of the Dead.
Meet me on the roof at 9 o'clock. Get out.
I don't believe
it.
We're
gonna get out in the chopper. We've got to survive. Somebody's got to survive.
They kill for one reason. They kill for food. They eat their victims.
Imagine, if you will, that something has gone terribly wrong.
Shoot it, man.
Now, accept the fact that there's no escaping the horrible consequences. George Romero brings back the dead. Night of the Living Dead has ended. Dawn of the Dead is here.
We must not be lulled by the concept that these are our family members or our friends. They are not. They will not respond to such emotions.
Operated dead. Post abandoned.
We may never get out of the room.
It's everywhere.
What the hell is it?
Looks like a shopping center, one of those big indoor malls.
What are they doing? Why do they come here?
Some kind of instinct, memory, what they used to do. This was an important place in their lives.
What is it?
We've got a war.
We have spawned our own savagery. Soon, it will consume us all. It is a horrible, hauntingly accurate vision of the mindless excesses of a society gone mad.
They must be destroyed on sight.
When there is no more room in hell, the dead will walk the earth.
We are down to the line, folks. We are down to the line.
Dawn of the Dead.
Listen, if you can imagine the furor of love, then maybe you'll hear these walls here. These windows answer. The Screaming Skull. The Screaming Skull is a motion picture magnificent in its horror. Therefore, this certificate assures burial service without cost to anyone in the audience who dies of fright while seeing The Screaming Skull. See the re-visualization of a woman scorned. See the vengeful violence of the undead. The Screaming Skull, starring Alex Nichol. See Terror from the Year 5000 and The Screaming Skull.
Supposing a more powerful form of royal jelly could be obtained. From the queen wasp, for example.
Socially, the queen wasp is on level with a black widow spider.
Oh, no. There might be danger.
Those are my terms, Mr. Fincher. Janet Starlin will be your next guinea.
A woman of fantastic desires. Sponsoring a scientist with fantastic theories. And demanding fantastic results.
How old do I look? Tell me! How old? 23.
The enzymes, they're going crazy. Miss Darling will kill her and tear her body to shreds.
Trail with four men and a girl to the territory of the four men who live by killing. A girl who has experienced so much that only sadistic brutality can thrill her. Vicious and violent men attempting the most daring of daylight robberies, enjoying midnight revelries until one orgy turns into a nightmare of terror. Ride the ski lift to the very top in thrills.
What I saw, you wouldn't believe.
Watch men who deal in death meet and fight the invincible beast from Haunted Cave.
Go back. Go back.
I've come to help you.
You can't help now.
Ten dead men's bodies were used to fashion Dr. Frankenstein's infamous creature. Tens of dozens of victims have kept Count Dracula alive for three centuries. Only one of these beings will survive their meeting.
All new, different, shocking. You've never seen anything like Dracula versus Frankenstein. In color, rated GP.
Angels, wild women. They're hot, hard, and mean. Too tough for any man. See Angels, wild women from Independent International. They're beautiful, baby. Beautiful. Angels, wild women. In color, rated R, under 17, not admitted without parent.
Ah, yeah.
What is it?
This is West Side Story star Russ Tamblyn at his dramatic best in the shocking new motion picture, Satan's Sadists.
Oh, you guys ain't gonna believe this. You know what his bag is? His bag is buzzing.
What?
He's a cop.
Here's a film your conscience will never let you forget. And it's wild beyond belief. Satan's Sadists.
I was born mean by the child.
Torn out of today's headlines, a shocking, realistic story of the wave of revolution and anarchy sweeping our country today. Satan's Sadists.
Human zombies rise from their coffins as living corpses. Voodoo witchcraft transforms beautiful women into thousand-year-old mummies.
I can't believe it.
It's true.
He must possess the living to stay alive. The zombies rise from their deathless sleep and stalk the city's dark streets for those lonely souls who will become their next tormented victims.
It's the sensuous Georgina Spelvin, star of The Devil and Miss Jones, in the screen's latest, toughest, action-packed story of Girls for Rent. This motion picture smashes open the dirty world of politicians, party girls, massage, and murder. It was too hot to tell before, but now the lid is off. Don't miss Girls for Rent, in color, rated R for adults.
Hey, you want to drive, huh?
Rev it up.
Action you've never seen races across your screen as you thrill to a new dimension in picture making. Carnival of Souls. This is the shocking story of a who crawled from the river to race through a nightmare, walking a tightrope between heaven and hell. From the unreal, she crashes through to reality. But try as she will to lead a normal life, she is torn from a goal. There's no privacy in a life. She's ever watched, tormented. Either it's her neighbor, desirous of her physically, watching her with his leering eye, or it's the evil eye of the man who taunts her, the man who wants her. From the bottom of the river they come. They reach for her. They demand that she dance with them at the Carnival of Souls. She is a girl driven mad by the relentless forces of the beyond. He will not relent as he comes for her again and again. She whirls between the real and the unreal, trying to cling to life.
I like being with you, really I do. I don't want to be alone tonight. I want to be near you.
Honey, you don't want to go in there all by yourself, do you?
But she must watch herself in death. She must dance at the Carnival of Souls held just for her. For they have come for her for the last time, claiming her as one of their own. Carnival of Souls arouses such emotion that the management has been forced to state positively no refunds. Carnival of Souls is the shocker of all time, guaranteed to sweep you into a new dimension of picture making. You can't afford to miss Carnival of Souls.
Ha 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 ha!
this fifth day of December in the year of our Lord 1648, by virtue of the power vested in us by our noble sovereign, this tribunal of hereby sentences you, the crimson executioner, to death. You will die by one of the very instruments you devised to torture and kill your innocent victims. You dared to take into your own hands the laws of both God and man. You set yourself up as both judge and executioner. You caused inhuman suffering and took life not from any sense of justice, but from hatred and self-gratification. You showed no mercy to your victims, and no mercy will be shown to you.
You'll never kill me. Move along. I'll return and be avenged. Turn around.
You fools.
All of you. I am the Crimson Executioner. This day shall be written in blood. No man can judge me. I am the supreme law. I shall have my revenge.
The seal of this tribunal will entomb forever both your body and your evil soul. Let no man dare to break the seal. You are accursed, eternally damned, as are these dungeons, as is this castle that has witnessed such indescribable horrors. Your castle will stand throughout the centuries as a reminder of the barbarism and cruelty committed within its walls. May the dust of time not erase from the memory of man the infamy of the Crimson Executioner.
Thank you.
Not bad. This seems exactly what we've been looking for.
From here, it looks great. Just what we need.
I think we should be able to wrap up our work here in a day.
This'll look good.
Come on, Nancy.
Gosh, I'm stiff from that long ride.
It's made to order.
Yeah.
Hey,
we don't want to lose you.
Sure looks gloomy. How would you girls like to have a castle this old to live in?
You'd have to be a creep to live in a place like this.
I'd love to have a house like this all for myself. Imagine the peace and beauty of living all alone.
You're a funny one, all right.
All right, girls.
Wonder what it looks like inside.
What's wrong? Are you tired?
I don't know what it is, Perry. I just feel very uneasy.
No.
Susie.
Let me alone, Raoul.
Don't be like that, baby.
Everybody will see it.
Have it your way.
Are you all dead?
Lay you any odds you want, our dear publisher will wind up saying, this place isn't suitable after all. Let's go home.
Hello, is everybody out?
If they're all out, how can anyone be in the house?
The brain has spelled it out.
I'm not just a dumb blonde, you know.
Who says you're a blonde?
Must be in.
Hello? Why doesn't anybody answer? Maybe nobody lives here. What a nuisance. Someone should have told me the castle's empty. We might as well try to get in anyway. Maybe one of the boys could scale that wall.
That's a job for Tarzan.
Who's going to volunteer to climb the wall?
Okay. Here comes Uncle Perry, the greatest acrobat in the world.
Boy, I bet he gets us inside.
Yeah, you're right. 3 years for unlawful breaking and entering.
Take care, Perry.
Me a bonus for this little stunt, a double whiskey. What about that?
I still think you're playing with fire.
You should know me by now. I'm not the kind of man to let obstacles get in my way. I'm a man of action.
Well, what do we do now?
We follow the leader. What else?
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the old family.
Let's go. What a funny place this is. Looks like a Frankenstein film set.
sure of it.
You Hawaiians are far too impressionable, Kinuyo.
Childish jokes all the time. Raoul. Raoul, take off that silly costume.
These uninhabited castles always have their family skeletons.
Uninhabited? There's not a trace of dust around here.
Who are you? What are you doing here?
I'm very sorry. Nobody answered the doorbell, and we thought the castle was empty. Could we speak to the owner? I'd like a word with him about a business matter. Could you take us to him?
Follow me.
Let's go.
The rest of you wait in there.
Stop where you are. How dare you force your way into my castle like this? What do you want here?
I want to apologize. We didn't think anyone lived here, that's all.
It's no excuse for trespassing. I don't like having my privacy disturbed.
I'm sorry, sir. You're quite right. My name is Parks. I'd like to explain. We've been scouting for suitable locations to photograph material for book jackets. I'm a publisher.
That's no concern of mine.
Look here, I'd like to show you one of my books. I'm preparing an anthology of horror.
He told you to stay where you were.
We took the liberty of coming in here only because no one answered our knocking at the door.
I don't like intrusion. I insist that you leave my castle immediately.
Could you make just one exception? We've been on the road for several days. Everybody's so tired.
I don't want any visitors here.
I'd be only too glad to pay, of course.
Pay? Now you're beginning to annoy me, Mr. Parks.
I know my friend didn't mean to offend you, and we ask you to forgive us.
Feet, everybody. We've been told to shove off. The master of the house doesn't like having visitors around.
What? Again? Oh, no. Not after all I went through to get you in here.
So we're right back where we started. One castle's too modern. One's too old. Why don't we build our own and get it over with?
Susie, but wouldn't it cost an awful lot of money to build one, huh?
Oh, can't you change his mind? We're all tired.
Well, I'm tired, too. But we have no choice. We've been told to go, and that's it. Let's get moving quickly, huh?
Edith.
Wait.
Perhaps I was a little too hasty, Mr. Parks. I'm not usually so inhospitable. I realize you must all be very tired.
You see, I don't usually receive people. You can stay here overnight, but I'll have to ask you to leave first thing in the morning.
Thank you, sir. We really do appreciate your kind hospitality. Do you mind if we take a few pictures?
All right. But please remember, I don't like to be disturbed. My servants will show you the chambers where you can do your work.
Perfect. Let's get to work, girls. We mustn't waste any time. Go and change quickly. Dermot, you'd better check out the setting we need. Edith, you go along with him. Good girl.
Come on, Edith.
Don't go near the dungeons. They're absolutely out of bounds for everybody.
Okay, we won't. Get moving, Dermot. We're in a hurry.
Flip over this one. Can you imagine finding a thing like this here? Wasn't it lucky?
I'll take credit for that. I found it.
Yeah.
Food for everybody.
Hey, Max, I want a bonus for finding this thing.
All right, we'll see about the bonuses. Now eat
it
quickly,
would be
huh?
Perfect for the Skeletrix series. Hey, that
fine,
looks great.
Boys, fine, but now let's get to work.
I'll take the food to the girls, right?
No, I'll take care of that myself.
What a picture this will make.
What's all this nonsense? I'm just like a father to you girls.
Turn around. We have to get into our costumes.
Okay, have your little games, but hurry up. We haven't any time to fool around. We've got work to do.
You can turn around now if you want.
Edith, bring the girls downstairs. We can't afford to waste any time.
All right.
How's the food?
Terrible.
As usual.
Ah, bottle of wine, they call it. It tastes like water.
Yeah, it's awful, isn't it? But I know where we can find real wine. I discovered where the cellar is. Come on, I'll show you.
See ya.
Come on, Terry.
You know, Perry, I wouldn't mind being the owner of this castle.
You can have it. It gives me the creeps.
Skeletons don't have nerves. What do you mean it gives you the creeps? Thank you.
Now, don't breathe. Perfect like that. Hmm. All right. Hold the pose. I want to take another shot. Edith, hand me the other camera, will you? Thanks. Now, don't move, darling. Hold it. You make a beautiful corpse, you do. Just keep it. That's right.
Mm, it's no fun being dead.
Nobody ever said it was.
You mean it?
You were very convinced.
Okay, gang,
just
come
imagine
on,
what Daddy will say when he sees this photo.
Go and change now.
Yeah.
Okay, Susie, it's your turn now.
Sure, here I am, but where's Perry? He's in it, too.
Here I am. Your personal skeleton, always ready to die at the hands of a beautiful woman.
No,
how are you going
to change Annie's first?
That's fine.
You're never around when you're needed.
Right, but look what I dug up for you.
Oh.
I'll go.
Hey. Got it.
Rick, can I have your knife a minute? Thanks. Kinumio, what is it?
Just a little homesick, I guess.
Are you all asleep over there? Get behind that camera, Dermot.
Now, Nancy, honey, give me the feeling of a cat. You know what I mean. Meow.
Meow.
Shh. Meow. Shh. No, Nancy, that's too domesticated. I want you to think wild, fierce. Meow.
Meow.
Meow. Can't you think like an alley cat? For instance, you're about to fight another cat for a fish head or something.
Meow.
No, no, Nancy, that's the intellectual approach. You'll never be an alley cat. Let's try something else. I've got an idea. There. Now, raise your leg up. Up, 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 up.
Oh.
That's it. That's it. Now, imagine you're floating in the air like a thistle blown by the wind. That's it. Beautiful. No, not like that. You've got to go up. Gently. That's right, baby. Now hold it. No, no. Can't you keep that arm over your head? Now everything's in place. Arm, leg, head, everything. Now don't move. Come on, Nancy. Get that lovely foot of yours up like a feather, like a thistle blown by the wind.
No, no, I can't, Dermot. It's too heavy. I can't.
Oh, do it for me, baby. Let's fly together. Hold it. Hold it.
And we're about here. There.
Dermot, can we take a break for a few minutes?
No, no. We've got to be finished before morning. Put the spots over there.
Okay.
What are you doing here?
I'd like to see the owner of the house.
It's not possible. My master doesn't want to be disturbed.
But tell him...
I said it's impossible.
Your master has a right to his privacy, but that's no way to speak to a lady.
Rick... You met the owner of the house. What's he like?
It's difficult to say, really. He was half hidden behind a table. Have you noticed the windows? They're all barred. What a strange place. If I was still a reporter, I bet I could discover a lot of interesting facts about this castle.
Rick, but why are you wasting your time on horror stories? You should be doing the kind of work you were cut out for, reporting.
I guess you're right, but I'm a little lazy. I've been taking the easy way out by doing this. I started out with the usual dreams and found out there's more money in writing this kind of commercial book. Edith, I realize I'm being indiscreet, but why did you want to speak to the owner of the castle?
Just curiosity. Nothing more than that.
Everything's ready, Dermot. Can I go?
Not more than a few minutes, though. Time's running short.
You bet. Come on, Susie.
Don't pull me like that.
Then come on.
But where?
Oh, come on.
Okay, I'm all set. Everybody out of the way. That's right. Hold that pose, Perry. Don't move. I'll be done in a minute. Now, here we go.
Perry! Oh, no!
Didn't you hear that yell?
I didn't hear anything at all. Come along.
Where are you taking me?
You'll find out.
Look at that. What is it?
I don't know. Maybe it was an old torture cell. You know these old castles. Nothing in it.
Let me alone, Raoul. I'm scared.
Susie. Susie.
Staying here won't help any. Come with me.
There's no point in disturbing my master. He's been informed already of what has happened down here. And he hopes that you will all remain calm.
The rope was badly worn, Rick. We overlooked that, I'm afraid.
Well, what are you going to do now?
I don't know. We'll see.
Remember, Rick, even the master of the house suggested that we keep calm. Tomorrow we notify the police.
What do you mean, tomorrow?
Listen. After all, it was only an accident. A tragic one. But an accident. And besides, it's too late now.
Look, Max, this double talk leaves me cold. What do you really mean?
Well, I'm an editor. You've got to see my point. I've a deadline to meet.
I know exactly how you feel, girls. But we must finish our work before daybreak.
With poor Perry lying dead?
Oh, it's a big tragedy. You know, Perry was like a son to me. Don't you think I have a heart like the rest of you?
How do I know? I never had a chance to see it.
Perry would have known what I meant.
Yeah, but he's dead, and I want to go on living.
I'll double your salary.
My life's worth more than that.
Triple it.
Okay, it's a deal.
Me too.
Then let's get back to work. Where's Susie?
I think she went off with Raoul.
It's just like her. They always disappear at the wrong moment. We'll worry about her later. Let's go back to work now.
Well, I thought I'd seen just about everything. But this kind of bargaining is really more than I can stand.
Rick, look at this.
Huh? What is it?
It's the negative of the photograph I took right when the accident occurred.
Poor Perry. What a terrible thing. What's this? What's that strange shadow near the frame of the door? It almost looks like a man's head.
Yes, it does. That's exactly what I thought. But it just can't be. Still, it does look like a man's head with a hood on.
Show up more clearly on the print.
It should. We'll see in a minute. I've done the best I could. Of course, it's only a small detail. There. This is the maximum enlargement I can make here. Of course, it's still not very clear.
This doesn't help us very much, I'm afraid. It's hardly at all visible. Huh? Do you think the negative could have been defective?
No, it was perfect.
May I see that photograph? I heard about the accident that took place tonight. A most appalling accident.
Unfortunately, it's blurred.
Yeah, it was out of focus.
Perhaps this will sound strange, but I've something to tell you that may provide an explanation of the shadow in your photograph. Have you ever heard of the Crimson Executioner?
Who did you say? The Crimson Executioner?
He was a maniac and a killer who was put to death for his crimes centuries ago. He was buried in his own castle.
What you don't know is that this is the castle where the Crimson Executioner lived and died. When I came here, the castle had been uninhabited for centuries. For me, it was ideal because I desired solitude. Everybody else feared the curse that had been placed on it. When they sealed up his tomb, the Crimson Executioner swore that he would avenge himself. He was a man of extraordinary physical strength, obsessed by an ideal of purity. For centuries, he was entombed. There in the dungeons, and only a seal has protected mankind from his supernatural powers. If the shadow in the photograph is the Crimson Executioner, I fear anything might happen. I had to tell you.
Ooh,
can see you two already know each other.
I've never had the pleasure. This is the first time I've seen this lady.
I must retire now. I'm a creature of habit. I hope you will sleep well. Good night.
Edith, I know the accident upset you. You're terribly tired. What happened was a very bad shock for you. Stop crying now. Go to Canuyo, hmm? Oh, she's been through more than the rest of us.
Think it's too daring?
No.
I bet Max will like it.
He always does.
Hi, girls. Has Susie come back yet?
No. Maybe we should go on without her. She'll be along.
You'll make a big hit in that costume, Annie.
Won't I, too?
What? Oh, no. What's gotten into you? You mustn't hide those beautiful legs of yours.
Desecrated your world of beauty with their sordidness. The day of the Crimson Executioner has now come.
I've been wondering about the owner of this castle.
Well, if you want my opinion, I think he's slightly off his nut.
You would be, too. If you lived isolated in this place, you'd end up the same way he is. Hey, Dermot.
Yeah?
Look at this. This must be where the executioner was killed, if the legend is true.
What is it? Looks like a coffin.
No, it was a medieval instrument of torture. The infamous Iron Maiden.
Susie!
What?
Dare say that this was an accident. Come on. Just as I thought. The rope wasn't worn. It was cut. At this point, there's only one explanation. Deliberate murder.
Deliberate murder? But why, Rick? It doesn't make any sense.
That's what we've got to find out. Any idea where Raoul is?
Raoul?
No, I don't mean he had anything to do with this. But perhaps he saw who did it. He was near Susie all the time. Here, take this. My car is the fastest we have. Go to the nearest police station and try and get help.
Okay, Rick, I will. But how about you?
Hmm?
What are you going to do? Stay here? With a murderer at large, you're all in danger.
I know, but it's impossible to leave with things as they are. And we've got to find Raoul. He might have some evidence.
I'll be as fast as I can.
How much longer do we have to wait now?
We get paid. Why should you care?
Yeah, you get pretty by the minute, girls. Take a look at this, Max. I have a new idea. I don't want the girls to know this yet. Susie's been murdered.
What's that?
So you like the idea?
Oh, sure. It's great.
We'd better watch out. Dermot's already on his way to the police station. Don't tell the girls. They'd only get panicky.
But then Perry was killed, too.
We completely agree.
Well, what do we do now?
I'll have a look around. You'd better stay with the girls. See you later.
I want to see your master right away.
No, he doesn't want to see anybody.
It's urgent that I see him no matter what, understand?
I said you can't see him.
Edith, what are you doing here?
I want you to see what I found. I'm sure you recognize her.
Edith, what's your portrait doing in this castle? Then you do know the owner.
Yes. Travis and I were engaged. Travis Anderson.
Isn't he the actor who disappeared several years ago?
Yes, he used to be a muscle man in costume films. It all happened so suddenly, so unexpectedly. He left without a word. He just vanished. He's always been a little strange. Even with me, he seemed so cold. Yet I'm certain that he really loved me. In all this time, I haven't stopped wondering why he ever disappeared like that. Now I found him here in this castle. I thought I recognized his voice, and now that I've found this, I know it's Travis. I must try to speak to him.
Edith, we have no time for that. You've got to trust me.
What is it?
I'll tell you later. Where's Canullo?
I left her downstairs when I went to find Travis.
There's not a moment to lose. We must find her.
What's happened, Rick?
Don't ask any questions. Hurry. We've got to reach the other.
Here's a choice of food and drink to satisfy anyone and everyone. You'll find something to please you to add to your evening's enjoyment. Something to please all tastes and age groups. It's 7 minutes till showtime.
Over there.
Over where?
Over there.
Over here?
No, over there.
Over there.
The warehouse is in danger. The goodies we must save. All officers report at once. The situation's grave. Go get them, boys. For this sake. The culprits must be stopped. We'll make the scene with our siren, your soda pop as pop. Aha! The guilty ones are trapped. We've now performed our mission. But the climax isn't kept until we have an intermission.
It's 6 minutes till showtime.
Thank you.
Martin Music Center carries a complete line of the finest musical instruments and supplies. Exclusive dealer for Hammond, Cable, and Meloid grand organs and pianos. Let Russ Parrish, manager, or Earl Nicola show you the beautiful new models of Hammond organs. Class instruction by the talented teaching staff makes learning easy and fun. So for all of your musical needs, visit Martin's Music Center, 537 North Columbus Street. It's 5 minutes till showtime. Enjoy your evening to the fullest. How about some snowy, crisp, and crunchy popcorn? That's a fine way to relax. Just sit and munch contentedly while you enjoy the show. Bring enough popcorn back for the whole family. Everyone likes popcorn. And now, Mom and Dad want a cup of good, satisfying coffee. That's the kind we serve, full of flavor and satisfaction.
Folks, it's really delicious, and we know you'll enjoy it, too. At our refreshment stand, you'll find these pizza pies, freshly baked to your order. Make sure you get yours and enjoy it now.
It's 4 minutes till showtime. What's your pleasure, sir or madam, and all you kiddies too? Sandwiches, freshly made from quality ingredients, soft drinks, cool, tangy, and refreshing. A hot dog? There you are, tender, juicy, done to a turn with some fixings. Hamburgers, ma'am? Just the way you like them. Meaty, moist, and broiled to perfection. Soft drinks, kiddies? Take your choice. Cold, tingly with flavor. All your favorite soft drinks for your selection. Something to eat for everyone. Soft drinks to make your evening complete. Delicious, fresh, and satisfying to help your entertainment reach the peak of family fun. It's 3 minutes till showtime.
Ice cream bars. It's the handy way to enjoy smooth, rich, creamy ice cream. Get some.
Yes, sir. The hot dogs at our concession stand do rate an appreciative whistle.
It's 2 minutes till showtime.
Yes, there's an air about hot coffee that's hard to resist. Full-bodied, refreshing hot coffee makes any time a pleasant interlude. Won't you have some now?
It's 1 minute till showtime.
Please remember to replace the speaker on the post when you leave the theater.
Settle back now, content, comfortable, well-fed, and ready for some fine entertainment. Is everybody happy? Then let's go. It's showtime.
Let's get back to the show.
And now for our feature presentation.
It's important that we all stay together.
But what's going on? I don't understand.
Save yourself while there's still a chance. Don't you see? It's a diabolical trap. It's impossible for anyone to reach me. These wires are connected to the bows on the wall. The slightest touch will release the arrows in every direction, and anyone nearby will be killed. Nobody can stop the mechanism that operates. The spider. It has poison in its claws. I'll be killed the moment it reaches me. Now it's hopeless.
Watch out, Rick.
Don't do it, Rick. You'll be killed. I tell you, it's hopeless. Don't do it, Rick. Leave me. It's no use. Please don't come any closer. You're mad to risk your life like this.
Thank you.
for me. It's the end for all of us. Give up, Rick. It's no use. It's too late. Rick.
The others. Hurry up. You've got to get out of that castle at once. At once.
No. No, Rick. No. Not without you.
Do what I tell you. Go away, Edith. Go away. Don't worry about me. Derby will be back here soon with the police. No use. We've been locked in.
No. What do we do?
Max. Max, what's happening? Where are the others?
I don't know, but don't lose your head. Just come on down here. Go and tell Rick that we need him.
All right.
We have to get out of here.
Rick! Rick, all the doors are locked. We can't get out.
Keep calm, Edith. We'll make it somehow. Just a minute.
Come any nearer. Don't touch me.
You were the murderer. Now I know it, Travis. How could you? You're a monster! A monster! Oh.
You. You no longer mean anything to me. Even though I missed you when I abandoned the world. I was forced to retreat to this castle. Mankind is made up of inferior creatures, spiritually and physically deformed, who would have corrupted the harmony of my perfect body.
Thank you.
I came to the isolation of this castle to avoid the contagion of human sentiment. And a woman's love. Would have destroyed me. It's because of that I abandoned you.
Travis, you've lost your sanity. You're an egotist, obsessed with your sick thoughts.
You're wrong, Edith. Last night I had a moment of weakness because of you. When I first caught sight of you, and I said you could stay together with your friends, but that was a mistake. I know of only one who was never overcome by weakness. The Crimson Executioner. He despised your world as passionately as I do. Look at him. Look at him. His magnificent body was preserved intact through all these centuries undisturbed. His spirit lives in me, and I'll continue his mission of vengeance. This is the sacred duty I've sworn to. We're alike. Now that you have profaned his tomb and broken the seal that imprisoned his great spirit, his power has been released at last. And his noble crusade against sin lives again through me. Yes, the black fire of the long-awaited vengeance is here. And your friends cannot escape. The Crimson Executioner has passed judgment. Now, at last, you'll witness the glory of his return. And you'll pay just like the others. For your lechery. The Crimson Executioner will torture you. Yes, will torture you. Till death.
Oh!
that's just a small portion of the torture that awaits you. I promise you that none will escape the wrath of the Crimson Executioner. As for Rick, this is how he will die.
Why are you doing this? Why don't you let us go? What have we done to you? You're torturing innocent people. Come back to your senses. You're the owner of this castle, not the Crimson Executioner.
Oh, see, I am the Crimson Executioner. An executioner invented the torture of icy water for creatures like you. My vengeance needs blood. An executioner cries out for blood. You better prepare to die. You sinner! Ah!
Mustn't worry about me. I'm not in danger. Try to find the others if you can, Rick. They're in Anderson's hands. He took them to the dungeons. He's insane. He thinks he's the Crimson Executioner. You've got to stop him, or he'll kill them all. Hurry, Rick!
Yes, but where are you, Edith?
Watch out!
You can't get away with this. Let me out of here. I'll pay you anything you want. What are you going to do now?
This fire will purify your miserable soul.
No.
You're impure. This fire will cleanse you.
No, you can't do this to me. Stop. I don't want to die like this. No. No, let me out.
Burn.
No, I don't want to die like this. No. No, let me out. Mercy!
Your turn.
Oh, Travis!
You'll pay too.
No! No! Let me go! Stop! Let me go! Travis, don't! Don't! Oh, please stop! Please let me go! You're mad!
Risen from his tomb, your atonement has just begun.
It's done. I killed the writer.
It's not true. No,
It's impossible. No.
They'll all die.
Oh! No, I can't stand this.
Oh, now I beg you, Travis. Oh. What you're doing is insane, Travis. Oh, my God. The Crimson Executioner.
No! Go away! I am the Crimson Executioner!
Rick!
It's impossible! It can't be! It's impossible that he's alive, I tell you! I killed him myself! I saw him die!
It wasn't me you murdered. You hit the dead body of poor Rao. I put his corpse in the tower, and that's what your arrow hit. You'll have to try again.
Kill him! Go on! Go on! Kill him, I said!
My body.
My pure body. Has been contaminated. The body of the Crimson Executioner.
He was completely mad. Like the Crimson Executioner, Travis was obsessed with a dream of absolute purity and physical perfection. That's why he retired to the isolation of this castle. Our intrusion into his world was too much for him. And it was then that he assumed the identity of the Crimson Executioner and decided to carry out the ancient legend of revenge. His striking resemblance to the real executioner made it easy for him to believe his own hallucination.
Striking resemblance? Anderson and his folly created the legendary executioner in his own image. The Crimson Executioner's been dust for centuries.
It was terrible. Please take me away from this castle. It was a nightmare.
I won't write any more horror stories. The man that said life is stranger than fiction made no mistake.